Assalamu alaikum everyone, welcome to Universal Forum. Today the topic which I am going to discuss with you is the escape velocity. So, what is the escape velocity? This is the initial velocity of an object with which it goes out of the Earth's gravitational field. In our daily life, we experience many object projection upward, come back to the ground after rising to a certain height. This is due to the force of gravity and which is acting on it and which attracts it to move downwards. So, with increased initial velocity, the object rises to the greater height before coming back. If we go increasing the initial velocity of an object, a stage comes when it will not return to the ground. It will escape out of the influence of the gravity. So, when the attraction of the gravitational field is zero, it means that the body is out of the gravitational field. So at that point we can explain the escape velocity. So for the body moving out of the gravitational field, it having some energy due to which that escape easily from the Earth's gravitational field. So for this, the initial kinetic energy which is gained by the body, which carries it to an infinity distance from the surface of the Earth. So if we can say that this is our earth and this inside our Earth there is all the gravitational field. So if the body is moving outward or escape from this boundary line, so this is the escape velocity, defined as the escape velocity of the body. So when the body gains a certain amount of kinetic energy, it moves to an infinity distance from the surface of Earth. So initial kinetic energy equal to half and we escape. So we know that work done in lifting a body from Earth's surface to an infinity distance is equals to the increase in its potential energy. We always know that whenever height covered or distance covered by the body, there is potential energy involved in it. So increased potential energy equals to 0 minus gmm over r. Here this is the final potential energy. We don't know about the final potential energy, so we consider it as a 0. So this is the initial kinetic energy, because we know that the initial potential energy of the body. So here this m is the mass of the Earth, and this r is the radius of the Earth. So and this quantity is the absolute potential energy. By calculating a derivation, we can easily evaluate the absolute potential energy. For this we have the certain kind of the involvements of the radius, work done, and by calculating this we can easily evaluate the absolute potential energy, which is equal to gmm over r. So here I am using just only the result of absolute potential energy. So the body will escape out of the gravitational field if the initial kinetic energy of the body is equal to increase in potential energy. It means that the potential energy and the kinetic energy both are the equals, then the body in lifting it up to the infinity, then the body is able to lifting it up to the infinity. So I say that the kinetic energy, initial kinetic energy, this is initial kinetic energy when it equals to the increase potential energy, this is the potential energy. When the both energies are equal, then the body are able to lift itself to the infinity. So by arranging this equation number, this equation, V scale equals to 2gmm over rm. Mm cancels with each other, so we left with the 2gmm over r. This is g is the gravitational energy, gravitational force, gravitational field of the Earth. This m is the mass of the Earth, and this r is the radius of the Earth. So taking square root, we have with the escape velocity equals to square root 2gmm over 2. By calculating the Earth's gravitational field, we have the g equals to gmm over r square. So by putting this g, we know that the g equals to the 9.8 meter per second minus 2. By putting the value of g m r square, we can easily evaluate the value of the g. So by putting the value of the g in here, we left with the VES C equals to square root 2 G R. So how it will comes equals to 2 G M this is the R, and if I say that equals to G M, so we can evaluate from here with the value of the capital G. G equals to G R square over M. If we can put this value of G into this equation, we can easily get 2 G R. So 2 G R square M over R M. So with M and M cancel with each other, and R cancel with each other, so we left with the 2 G R. So we can easily evaluate the value of the escape velocity. By calculating the escape velocity of the Earth, we know that the radius of the Earth, which is known to be the capital R equals to 6.4 into 10 to power 6, and G equals to 9.8 meter per second minus 2. If you can putting these two values in this escape velocity's equation, so we can easily get the escape velocity of the Earth. So this is the escape velocity of the Earth. Whenever anybody wants to go out from the Earth or want to move around the Earth, so it needs having this having the velocity, which is approximately equal to 11.2 meter per second, then it can easily go out from the Earth. So here we have the some information about the escape speeds, or the this is the kilometer escape speeds of the of many bodies. So we have the moon. Suppose we have moon. If we want to escape from the moon, so we need 2.4 kilometer per second minus 1. We have this kind of the escape velocity, this amount of the. If we are moving out of the Mercury, we have the 4.3 kilometer per second minus 1. And if we are moving from the Venus, 10.4 kilometer per second minus 1. So there is we have this move of escape velocities for the moon, for the Mercury, and for the Venus. These all are the calculating from the respective equation. As we know that from the general equation of the escape velocity, if we are know about the gravitational field of the moon and the g of the moon, we can say, or the radius of the moon, we can put in this g and r of the moon in this equation, we can easily get the escape velocity of the moon, which is equal to 2.4 kilometer per second minus 1. So similarly, if we want to the escape velocity of the Mercury, we can also have the radius of the Mercury and g of the Mercury. Then we can put in this general equation, which is equal to escape velocity equals to square root 2 g r. So we have the escape velocity of the Mercury equals to 4.3 kilometer per second minus 1. So similarly, Venus equals to 10.4 kilometer per second. And we have the scale velocity of the Uranus, Neptune, Saturn, Jupiter, and the Mars as well. So hope so you people like my videos. Kindly subscribe my video, and don't forget to share and subscribe my video. So Allah Hafiz. Stay tuned with me.